So in this presentation, we will discuss the regarding the basic or mathematical tools which we use in the quantum mechanics, or you can say which we need for the formulation of formalism of the quantum mechanics. So and we restrict ourselves only here to the practical issues that are relevant to the formalism of the quantum mechanics. And everyone know that in quantum mechanics, but we can't neglect the classical mechanics, because everyone like to bag out the classical physics, but it served us pretty well for quite a while. However, the experimental results are related to the double slit experiment or some photoelectric effect that didn't match up well with the known understanding of the time, because at that time the Newtonian physics or classical physics were not able to explain these experiments. So the people think that we have to develop the new theory, and then they start formulating the formula for the quantum mechanics. So here we will discuss the tools which we need for the formalism of the quantum mechanics, or which need to study the quantum mechanics. And there you know that there is Schrodinger equation, and you know that this is a partial differential equation, and that can describe the dynamics of the quantum mechanical systems via the, you can say, the wave function, which is the parameter, okay, and the trajectory as well as the positioning as well as the energy of those systems, quantum mechanical systems, can be retrieved by solving the Schrodinger equation. And we know that all information that is regarding the subatomic particle is lie within a wave function, and the wave function will satisfy and can be solved by using this Schrodinger equation. And you know that when we talk in the formalism of the quantum mechanics, that deals with the operator, which should be linear. And you know that the wave function that belongs to the space, that abstract Hilbert space or vector space. And we know that this quantum mechanics was formulated by the Schrodinger and Heisenberg. And Heisenberg will use the wave mechanics approach, whereas the Heisenberg use the matrix mechanics for the formalism of the quantum mechanics. And we know that if we want to have the proper knowledge about the formalism of quantum mechanics, so knowledge and property of the Hilbert space, that is essential. So we need the deep learning of the spaces, vector spaces, in the quantum mechanics. As you know that vector space, basically it is a collection of objects or elements that can be added or multiplied by the scalar. And these objects or elements, these collection of elements, they must follow certain rules. For example, if we consider the three-dimensional space, and if we add the, for example, ordinary vectors, so we can use the vector addition. For example, if we want to add the vector, we simply use the vector calculus for their addition. And now in this type of, if we are dealing with the elements which are vector in quantity, so their addition is different from the ordinary way of adding the things. Or we can say that for adding vector quantities of these elements, we need certain set of the rules. So in quantum mechanics, we can say that all possible states of a system, they form the vector space. So now in the next slide, we will discuss the vector spaces which we use, which we must understand in quantum mechanics. So that is the linear vector space. So in linear vector space, as we earlier said, that it is a collection of set of elements. So here in linear vector space, we will consider that it consists of two set of elements, that is set of vectors that I have written is psi, phi, psi, and many more, and also have the set of scalars a, b, c, up to n scalar, you can say. And these set of elements or set of vectors and set of scalars, we can manipulate them using algebraic rules like vector addition or the scalar multiplication in a similar fashion as we do in the vector calculus. So what are the vector addition? That because these group, the set of elements or set of vectors, set of scalars, they must know the what are the property and structure of abelian group, and that what are the addition rule for those set of vectors and set of scalars, that we will discuss here. If I remember, if I am considering that psi and phi two vector or elements of a space, of a given space, then I can write sum is psi plus phi, and this psi plus phi is again a vector quantity, and this the vector, this third vector you can say, which is sum of these two elements, that also belongs to same space. So this is one property of addition, that if we have the set of element, if we add 1, 2, 3, for example, if I adding psi phi plus psi, then this summation will give me another vector, and that vector also belongs to this the given vector, given space. We can't say that this on adding it will belongs to different vector space. And it follow the commutative law. For example, if I can write a psi plus phi, so that is equal to phi plus psi. So the addition is independent of order of adding, way of you are adding. Yeah, either you adding psi plus phi or you adding phi plus psi. So it the value is not depend upon the this parameter. So it is independent. And there is another is the commutative under the addition. So in this addition again, that is same repeating, and the associativity. So in associativity, for example, if I'm adding here three vector elements psi plus phi, if I'm adding these two, and then if I add with the third one, or I'm adding first quantity after by adding psi plus phi, and then I will add to phi. So in both cases, they are equivalent. So you can say that it also associative law for addition, your vectors, that it always follow that law also. So they are equivalent. So this is another, and another thing is that in this vector space, the linear vector space, there is also existence of a zero vector. That, for example, if I are adding here psi plus zero or zero or neutral vector or zero plus psi, which is equal to psi. So again, because you are adding the vector whose magnitude is zero, so that quantity again comes. You are there is no change on the addition. So there is existence of zero vector or neutral vector, and that is also belongs to that space. And another is there is also existence of a symmetric or inverse vector. That is, if you have psi, there is also existence of minus psi with negative sign. Or phi, if you have phi, then there is also existence of its inverse vector, that is minus phi. And if we have this psi plus minus psi, so you know in magnitude of commutative way, they are same. And next is rule is the multiplication rule, that when we manipulate these vector quantities with the scalars, and you know scalar may be the real or complex number, so the properties which they follow the set of vectors, for example, if you have the psi and phi two vectors in the outer space, if I take the linear combination of psi and phi in this way, A is a scalar multiplying with psi and B scalar multiply with phi, so this is a linear combination of these two vectors. So this, if we wrote a linear combination of these two given vectors, that is also again a vector quantity, it is also vector, and it also belongs to same vector space, linear vector space. For example, here we are discussing the linear vector, so this is again belongs to linear vector space. And another is distributivity with respect to addition vector, means that, for example, here I am multiplying the scalar and taking the summation of sum of two elements psi plus phi, so that is equivalent to a psi plus a phi. Or if I write a plus b scalar quantities multiplied with the psi, I can write a psi plus b psi, so that is equivalent. So this is also follow these distributivity rule or the law with respect to the vector addition, you can say. And another is the associativity with respect to multiplication of scalar, that if I am multiplying b psi, if I am taking b psi, if I multiply with a, which is equivalent to, if I taking the a b product and then I multiply with psi, so both they are equivalent, they are same. So these scalars or multiplication rule follow the these property, and these products belong to same vector space. And another thing is that for each element, whether it is psi or phi or xi or any nth element, there must exist a unitary of unitary scalar. That here I multiply this scalar I with the psi, or we multiply element with this scalar, both are equivalent, it doesn't affect the this psi. And another thing is that for each element psi, there must exist a zero scalar. Earlier we talked that neutral vector, in similar fashion here we have scalar zero. So if zero scalar, if I multiply scalar, this zero scalar with function, I can write this, or multiply psi with the zero scalar, the result comes out to be zero. So, and this is the another property related to the linear